Hi, today I am going to discuss about cell injury. First of all, what is cell injury? Cell injury is the effect of stresses due to variety of etiological agent on the cell. So cell injury is the effect of stresses due to variety of etiological agents on the cell. When disease occurs due to alteration of the function of tissues or cells at the microscopic level, the various causes of cell injury include. First cause is hypoxia. It is the most common cause of cell injury. It results due to decrease in oxygen supply to the cell. Hypoxia may be caused by ischemia, anemia, and cardiorespiratory disease. What is hypoxia? It is the most common cause of cell injury. It results due to decrease in oxygen supply to the cell. Hypoxia may be caused by ischemia, anemia, cardiorespiratory disease. What is ischemia? Ischemia results due to decrease in blood supply. It is the most common cause of hypoxia. It is a question. What is anemia? It results due to decrease in oxygen carrying capacity of the blood. And what is the result of cardiorespiratory disease? It results from decreased oxygenation of blood due to cardiac or respiratory disease. So hypoxia caused by three things: ischemia, anemia, and cardiorespiratory disease. Ischemia means decrease in blood supply. Ischemia occurs. Anemia occurs when decrease in oxygen carrying capacity of blood. And cardiorespiratory disease occurs when decreased oxygenation of blood due to cardiac or respiratory disease. From the recent exam question, neurons are the most sensitive cells in the body. They are most commonly damaged due to global hypoxia. So in case of global hypoxia, there is damaging of neurons, which is sensitive cells of the body, most sensitive cells of the body. Next cause of the cell injury is physical agent. Cell injury may occur due to the radiation exposure, pressure, burns, and frostbite. Next cause is chemical agent. Many drugs, poisons, chemicals can result in cell injury. Next is infection. Various infectious agents like bacteria, virus, fungus, parasite, etc. can cause cell injury. Next is immunological reaction. This include hypersensitivity reaction and autoimmune disease. Genetic cause. Cell injury can also result due to derangement of the gene. So, and last but not least, that is a cause, nutritional imbalance. Cell injury can result due to deficiency of vitamins and minerals. So, cell injury occurs by 7 causes. One is hypoxia, second one is physical agent, third is chemical agents, fourth is infection, fifth is immunological reaction, sixth is genetic cause, and seventh is nutritional imbalance. So at a cellular level, The protective effect in mammalian cell against hypoxic injury is induction of a transcription factor called hypoxia inducible factor 1, which promotes blood vessels formation, stimulates cell survival pathways, and enhances anaerobic glycolysis. The only reliable clinical strategy to decrease ischemic brain and spinal cord injury is transient reduction of core body temperature to 92 degrees Fahrenheit. It is the concept. In response to injury, a cell or tissue can have following consequences. First one is adaptation. The cell changes its physiological function in response to an injurious stimulus. And second one is reversible cell injury and irreversible cell injury. These two types of cell injury are there. Now, reversible cell injury. Reversible cell injury, as already discussed, hypoxia is the most common cause of cell injury. Oxygen is an important requirement of mitochondria for the formation of ATP. Therefore, hypoxia will result in earliest involvement of mitochondria. So, reversible cell injury occurs only due to hypoxia. So, hypoxia is the most common cause for reversible cell injury, which result the earliest involvement of mitochondria. Hypoxia will result in earliest involvement of mitochondria. Because oxygen is the important requirement of mitochondria for the formation of ATP. Therefore, hypoxia will result in earliest involvement of mitochondria, resulting in decreased formation of ATP. All cellular processes requiring ATP for normal functioning will be affected. Important organelles affected are cell membranes, require ATP for functioning of sodium potassium pump, and second one is endoplasmic reticulum, which requires ATP for protein synthesis, and nucleus. So in case of hypoxia, when mitochondria is involved, at that time, three organelles mostly affected. One is cell membranes, second one is endoplasmic reticulum, and third one is nucleus. Cell membrane affects due to requirement of ATP for functioning of sodium and potassium pump is going to decrease. In case of endoplasmic reticulum, there is requirement of ATP for protein synthesis. When mitochondrial action is damaged or decreased, then ATP not properly synthesized. So endoplasmic reticulum cannot synthesize properly proteins in protein synthesis, cannot take part in the synthesis of protein, and nucleus also damage. Mitochondria is the earliest organelle affected in the cell injury. Myelin fibers are made up of phospholipids. These two points very important. So ischemia means decrease of oxygen supply, means mitochondria affected, After that, oxidative phosphorylation get decreased. Then ATP synthesis got decreased. Then decrease in activity of sodium potassium ATPase pump, anaerobic respiration and other effects. When decreasing activity of the sodium potassium ATPase pump, there is increase in flux of water and sodium and efflux of potassium, which results endoplasmic reticulum swelling, cellular swelling, loss of microvilli, blebs and myelin fibers. In case of anaerobic respiration, that anaerobic respiration also affected due to decrease of ATP and oxidative phosphorylation. Then increase of glycogenolysis, decrease pH. When decrease glycogenolysis, there is decrease of, when increase glycogenolysis, there is decrease of glycogen. When decrease pH, there is clumping of nuclear chromatin. And other effects are detachment of ribosome, decreased protein synthesis and lipid deposition. So when ischemia occurs, there is oxygen supply decrease, mitochondria affected, oxidative phosphorylation decreased, ATP decreased, activity of sodium potassium ATPase pump decreased, then influx, which affects influx of water and sodium and increase efflux of potassium, which results endoplasmic reticulum swelling, cellular swelling, loss of microvilli, blebs and myelin fibers. Other effects is anaerobic respiration, which result increased glycogenolysis, decreased glycogen, decreased pH, then clumping of nuclear chromatin occurs, and other effects, detachment of ribosome, decreased protein synthesis, and which results finally lipid deposition. So 2 points remember: mitochondria is the earliest organelle affected in cell injury, and myelin fibers are made up of phospholipids, and hypoxia causes 3/3 by ischemia, anemia and cardiorespiratory disease. Ischemia occurs decrease in blood supply, when decrease in blood supply. Anemia occurs due to decrease in oxygen carrying capacity of blood, and cardiorespiratory disease occurs decrease oxygenation of the blood due to cardiac or respiratory disease. So swelling of organelles like endoplasmic reticulum result in decrease in protein synthesis. Bleb formation results due to outpouching from the cell membrane to accommodate more water, loss of microvilli and formation of myelin fibers due to breakdown of membranes of cellular organelles like endoplasmic reticulum. These are composed of phospholipids. Myelin fibers are intracellular holes of laminated lipid material resembling myelin of nerves. When these are present in membrane bound structures containing lysosomal enzyme, these are known as myeloid body or myelinoid bodies. So when these are present in membrane bound structure containing lysosomal enzyme, this myelin figure, okay, which is intracellular holes of laminated lipid material resembling myelin of nerve, When these are present in membrane-bound structure containing lysosomal enzyme, these are known as myeloid bodies or myelinoid bodies. Okay. Next is hydrophobic change. What is hydrophobic change or swelling of the cell? It is due to occur when increased water entry is the earliest change seen in reversible cell injury. So, in case of reversible change, there is hydrophobic change or swelling is present due to increased water entry is the earliest change. All the features discussed above are the reversible cell injury, because if the injurious agent is removed at this point, cell can recover back to its normal state or function and functioning. However, if the stimulus continues, the irreversible cell injuries ensues. So, hypoxia is the most common cause of cell injury, and ischemia is the most common cause of the hypoxia. Neuron which is most susceptible to hypoxia and irreversible damage occurs 5 minutes after global hypoxia. Fast cellular change in hypoxia is decreased oxidative phosphorylation in mitochondria. And watershed areas is defined as the region between terminal branches of arterial blood supply, where blood supply does not overlap. They are susceptible to hypoxic injury. Watershed areas examples are cerebral vessels and mesenteric arteries. These are the important definition and points which is remembered by you, which is needed for you. Next is irreversible cell injury. Irreversible cell injury, in this case, cell cannot recover back to its normal state of functioning. Irreversible cell injury include damage of cell membrane, which result due to continued influx of water, loss of membrane phospholipids, loss of protective amino acid like glycine. Damage to cell membrane result in massive influx of calcium. So, damage of cell membranes is one of the cause of irreversible cell injury. Next one is calcium influx. Massive influx of calcium to plus result in the formation of large flocculent mitochondria densities and activation of enzymes. So second cause is calcium influx. Third is nuclear changes. These are the most specific microscopic feature of irreversible cell injury. This includes pycnosis and karyokexis and karyolysis. Pycnosis means nuclear condensation, karyokexis means fragmentation of nucleus, and karyolysis means nuclear dissolution. Inability to reverse mitochondrial dysfunction and development of profound disturbance in membrane function characterize irreversibility. From the recent examination view, increased calcium, reactive oxygen species, and oxygen deprivation can cause damage of mitochondria. So, damage of mitochondria occurs due to increased calcium, reactive oxygen species, and oxygen deprivation. So, when prolonged ischemia, there is decreased ATP.
more decrease in HB due to prolonged ischemia.
Then increased calcium in the cytosol, which causes, first one is activation of enzymes and second one is calcium deposition in the mitochondria. When activation of the enzyme, which results secretion of three types of enzyme, one is phospholipase, second one is protease, and third one is nuclease. The phospholipase damage the cell membrane, protease damage the protein, and nuclease causes pycnosis, karyolysis, karyohexis. When calcium deposition in the mitochondria, that result mitochondrial densities or amorphous densities increase. Here, these changes lead to cell death by necrosis. Now, I am going to discuss about necrosis. First, necrosis and apoptosis, these two things are there. Necrosis is always pathological, associated with disruption of cellular homeostasis, example ischemia, hypoxia, and poisoning. There is several types of necrosis. First one is coagulative necrosis. Second one is liquefactive necrosis, cessative necrosis, fat necrosis, fibrinoid necrosis, gangrenous necrosis. I will discuss in a shortest manner the all types of necrosis. It is helpful for your NIT PG or any other exam after undergraduate level. So in necrosis, you should know the definition of the necrosis. So what is necrosis? Morphological changes indicative of cell death in a living tissue following harmful injury. Necrosis is an accidental and unregulated form of cell death. It results from damage to cell membranes and loss of ion homeostasis. Morphologically, these general changes occurring in the necrotic cell and cytoplasmic changes which increase when increased eosinophilia and have glassy homogeneous appearance. So first type of the necrosis, coagulative necrosis. Most common type of the necrosis, loss of nucleus with the cellular outline being preserved, which is associated with the ischemia, and it is seen in the most of the organ like heart, liver, kidney, etc., except brain. So coagulative necrosis is the most common type of the necrosis, and it is seen in most of the organ except brain. Liquefactive necrosis. It is enzymatic destruction of cells. It occurs in case of abscess formation, pancreatitis, It is seen in brain. Caseous necrosis. It is combination of coagulative and liquefactive necrosis. It is cheese-like appearance of the necrotic material. It characteristics of TB in case of tuberculosis. Also seen in syphilis, histoplasmosis and coccidioidomycosis. Coccidioidomycosis. Fat necrosis. Action of lipase on the fatty tissue. It is seen in breast, omentum and pancreatitis. Fibrinoid necrosis. It is complexes of antigens and antibody are deposited in vessel wall with leakage of fibrinogen out of the vessel. It is seen in pan-astrobodies, in rheumatic heart disease and malignant hypertension. Gangrenous necrosis, surgical use term necrosis of tissue with superadded putrefaction. Dry gangrene and wet gangrene. Dry gangrene is similar to coagulative necrosis and wet gangrene is similar to liquefactive necrosis, and it is due to secondary infection. Noma is a gangrenous lesion of vulva or mouth, and Fournier's gangrene is seen in scrotum. So irreversible cell injury may be necrosis or apoptosis. What is apoptosis? It is programmed cell death. Coagulative necrosis is associated with tombstone appearance of the affected tissue. Tombstone appearance of the affected tissue. So morphologically, I give a difference in between all types of necrosis by morphologically. First one is coagulative necrosis. In case of gross morphology is organ affected, all organ except brain. More frequent in organ supplied by end artery with limited collateral circulation such as heart, kidney, spleen and limb. Appearance involved region appear dry, pale, yellow and firm. It is waste separate in organs like kidney and spleen. Microscopic structure is indistinct outline of dead tissue. Here nucleus may be either absent or so karyolysis. Coagulative necrosis main causes ischemia. Ischemia is the main cause by obstruction in a vessel. In case of liquefactive necrosis, the gross morphology is organ affected or brain. Necrotic area is soft and center, so liquefaction. Abscess anywhere, localized collection of pus is called abscess. It is also seen in wet gangrene and pancreatic necrosis. Microscopic view, pus consists of liquefactive necrotic cell debris, dead leukocytes and macrophages, scavenger cells. Caseous necrosis. Caseous necrosis mainly cause in tuberculosis or TB due to hypersensitivity reactions. Gross morphology, organ affected first. Tuberculosis may involve any organ, most common in lungs and lymph node. Its appearance Necrotic area appears yellow, white, soft, friable, granular, and resembles dry, clumpy cheese, hence the name caseous or cheese-like necrosis. Microscopic view, focal lesions of tuberculosis is a granuloma, which may casseting soft granuloma or non-casseting hard granuloma. Caseous necrosis is a collection of fragmented or lysed cells and appears as eosinophilic, coarsely granular material. In contrast to coagulative necrosis, there is a complete obliteration of the tissue architecture and it is not possible to identify the cellular outlines. It is surrounded by epithelioid cells, Langerhans type of giant cells, nuclei arranged in a horseshoe pattern, lymphocytes and fibroblasts forming granuloma. Caseous necrotic material may undergo dystrophic calcification. So caseous necrotic material may undergo dystrophic calcification. In case of fat necrosis, it refers focal area of the fat destruction, which affects adipose tissue. There is two types of fat necrosis: enzymatic fat necrosis and traumatic fat necrosis. Enzymatic fat necrosis occurs in adipose tissue around acutely inflamed pancreas in case of acute pancreatitis, and traumatic fat necrosis occurs in tissue with high fat content like a breast and thigh following severe trauma. Morphologically, in case of gross morphology, appears as chalky white areas, and microscopy, the necrotic fat cells appear pale with shadowy outline surrounded by an inflammatory reaction. Fibrinoid necrosis, characterized by deposition of pink staining fibrin-like proteinaceous material in the tissue matrix with a staining pattern reminiscent of fibrin. Next is gangrene or gangrenous necrosis. Definition: it is the most massive necrosis with superadded putrefaction. So types is two types, namely dry and wet gangrene. The variant of wet gangrene, known as gas gangrene, is caused by Clostridia gram-positive anaerobic bacteria. Dry gangrene, which causes by arterial occlusion, in case of example atherosclerosis site, it is usually involves a limbs, generally the distal part of the lower limb. Morphology: gross, affected part is dry, shrunken and dark brown or black, resembling the foot of mummy. The black color is due to the iron sulfide. A line of demarcation is seen between the gangrenous and adjacent normal area. Microscopic view, the necrosis which is coagulative type, so submerging of soft tissue overlying skin. The line of demarcation consists of granulation tissue with inflammatory cell. Wet gangrene, which is caused by or due to the venous blockage in case of strangulated hernia, intersusception or valvulus. Diabetic patients may develop both dry due to atherosclerosis of the tibial and popliteal artery and wet gangrene. It is usually follows a minor injury to the toe or foot site, occur in most tissue or organs. Gross morphologically, the affected part is soft, swollen, putrid and dark, no clear line of demarcation. Microscopically, liquefactive type of necrosis. So now I give a difference. I tell you a difference in between dry gangrene and wet gangrene. Dry gangrene and wet gangrene. First is dry gangrene and second is wet gangrene. Common site in case of dry gangrene, limbs, wet gangrene, bowels. Example for dry gangrene, gangrene due to atherosclerotic narrowing of blood vessels of the lower limb, and in case of wet gangrene, volvulus and intersusception. Etiological factor, cause of ischemia. In case of dry gangrene, arterial obstruction. In case of wet gangrene, common venous obstruction. Rate of obstruction. In case of dry gangrene, slow obstruction. And in case of wet gangrene, abrupt. Gross feature, appearance of involved part, shaped, dry and black. And in case of wet gangrene, swollen, soft and moist or wet. Line of demarcation, clear cut between gangrenous and healthy part. And in case of wet gangrene, there is no clear cut. Spread, slowly spread in case of dry gangrene, rapidly spread in case of wet gangrene. Prognosis, in case of dry gangrene, that is fair, and in case of wet gangrene, poor due to severe septicemia. So next is apoptosis. What is apoptosis? Apoptosis is a type of cell death induced by tightly regulated suicide program. It is characteristic by activation of the intrinsic enzyme of the cell that degrade its own nuclear DNA and protein, both nuclear and cytoplasmic. Causes of apoptosis. Now, there is two types of causes. First one is physiological causes and second is pathological causes. In case of physiological, first one is removal of excess cell during embryogenesis and development process. Second one is elimination of the cells after withdrawal or hormonal stimuli. In case of endometrial cell breakdown during the menstrual cycle. Third one is elimination of the cells after withdrawal of tropic stimuli. Example, neutrophils is an acute inflammatory response. Lymphocytes after immune response. And fourth one is elimination of the potentially harmful cell. In immunology, the clones of self-reactive lymphocytes that recognize normal cell antigens are deleted by apoptosis. Pathological condition. Elimination of the cells are damaged DNA. So, next is elimination of the cell with excessively accumulated misfolded protein. Third one is killing of viral infected cell. Fifth one is elimination of neoplastic cells or rejection of transplant. And fifth one is elimination of parenchymal cells in pathologic atrophy. So, these are the physiological and pathological causes of apoptosis, which is programmed cell death. Now I am going to discuss about apoptosis or programmed cell death, which is induced by intrinsic or extrinsic pathway. Normally, growth factors bind to their receptors in the cells, prevent the release of cytochrome C and SMSC. So, withdrawal or absence of growth factors can result in release of this mediator, initiate the intrinsic factor. Intrinsic pathway. It is initiated by the release of cytochrome C and SMAC, which is second mitochondrial activator of caspases. from the mitochondrial intramembrane space. Cytoplasmic cytochrome C stimulates APAF1 apoptosis activating factor 1, leading to sequential activation of caspase 9 and effector caspase like caspases 3 and 7. On the other hand, the released SMAC binds and blocks the function of the caspases inhibitor IAPS, inhibitor of apoptosis proteins. So this is the intrinsic pathway. So repeatedly, intrinsic pathway initiated by release of cytochrome C and SMAC, which is second mitochondrial activator of caspases, from the mitochondrial intermembrane spaces. This is released. One is cytochrome C and SMAC. Next, cytoplasmic cytochrome C, which stimulates APAF1, which is apoptosis activating factor 1, leading to sequential activation of caspase 9 and effector caspases 3 and 7. On the other hand, the released SMAC, which is second mitochondrial activator of caspases, which binds and blocks the function of caspases inhibitor IAPS, inhibitor of apoptosis protein. Next is extrinsic pathway. Extrinsic pathway is activated by binding of FAS ligand to CD95, FAS membrane of TNF receptor family, or binding of TRAIL, TNF related apoptosis inducing ligand. To death receptor DR4 and DR5. This induces the association of FADD, FAS associated death domain, and procaspase 8 to death domain motifs of the receptors, resulting in activation of the caspase 8 in human caspase 10, which finally activate caspases 3 and 7, that are the final effector caspases. A cellular protein called FLIP binds to procaspase 8 but cannot activate it. This is important because some viruses produce homologs of FLIP and protect themselves from fast mediated apoptosis. This is the extrinsic pathway. From a recent examination view, remember two things: cytosolic cytochrome C apoptosis, and other one is mitochondrial cytochrome C electron transport chain. And another one, initiator caspase are caspase 8, 9, 10, and executioner caspase are caspase 3 and 6. So, extrinsic and intrinsic pathway of the apoptosis are completed. Now, I give a summarized manner of both pathway. Apoptosis, extrinsic pathway, which gives two things: TRAIL and FAS ligand. TRAIL binds to the DR4 and DR5, and FAS ligand binds to CD95. That both are binds and associate with FADD and procaspase 8 to death domain, which activate the caspase 8 or caspase 10 in humans. In case of intrinsic pathway, which is also called mitochondrial pathway, remember it, that gives cytochrome C release from the mitochondria to cytoplasm, and second one is release of SMAC or DIABLO from mitochondria. Cytochrome C released from the mitochondria to cytoplasm, which binds to APF AFP-AF1, then wheel-like hexamer is formed, then activation of the caspase 9, and release where release of SMAC, which binds to the binds and neutralize the IAPS. IAP means inhibitor of apoptosis protein. Okay. Then from the extrinsic pathway, activation of the caspase 8 or caspase 10 in humans, and from the intrinsic pathway, activation of the caspase 9. That these both are associate and activate of effector caspase, which is caspase 3 and 7. Very important. Then it activate substrate cleavage, then morphological features of apoptosis, which causes morphological features of apoptosis. Condensation of the nuclear chromatin is the most characteristic feature of the apoptosis. Caspase independent programmed cell death is called necroptosis. Okay, it is the most important thing. What is necroptosis? Caspase independent programmed cell death is called necroptosis. Now, regulation of apoptosis. Regulation is primarily by BCL2 family of genes located on the chromosome 18. Some members of this family like BAC, BID, BIN and BCLXS to remember S for stimulate apoptosis. Apoptosis, whereas others like BCL2, BCLXL to remember L for lower apoptosis, S for stimulate apoptosis and L for lower apoptosis. So this inhibit apoptosis. So BAK, BID, BIN, BCLXS stimulate apoptosis, whereas BCL2, BCLXL inhibit apoptosis. Normal cell have BCL2 and BCLXL. Normal cell have BCL2 and BCLXL present in the mitochondrial membrane. They inhibit apoptosis because their protein products prevent the leakage of mitochondrial cytochrome C into the cytoplasm. When there is absence of growth factor or hormones, BCL2, BCLXL are replaced by BAX and BIN etc. Resulting in increased permeability of the mitochondrial membrane. This result in stimulation of intrinsic pathway of apoptosis. Now, key points are apoptosis affects only single cells or small group of cells. Apoptotic cells express molecules facilitating their uptake by adjacent cells and macrophages. This leads to absence of inflammatory response in apoptosis. On agarose gel electrophoresis, ladder patterns is seen in apoptosis. Okay. Next. What is the difference between necrosis and apoptosis? Necrosis always pathological. Apoptosis may be pathological or physiological. Necrosis is associated with disruption of cellular homeostasis, example ischemia, hypoxia and poisoning. In case of apoptosis, it is important for development, homeostasis and elimination of pathogens and tumor cells. Necrosis affects contiguous group of cell. Apoptosis affect single cell. In necrosis, cell size is increased. In apoptosis, cell size is shrunken. In necrosis, cell size necrosis is passive, apoptosis is active. In necrosis, there is cause of inflammatory reaction. In case of apoptosis, no inflammatory reaction. In necrosis, plasma membrane disrupted. In apoptosis, plasma membrane is intact. In necrosis, smear pattern on electrophoresis. In apoptosis, tape letter pattern is seen. Now, what is pyroptosis? Pyroptosis occurs in cells infected by microbes. It involves activation of the caspase 1, which cleaves a precursor form of IL-1 to generate biologically active IL-1. Caspase 1 along with the closely related caspase 2, closely related caspase 11 also lead to death of the infected cell. So,
hello.
Next is next is metaplasia and dysplasia difference. If metaplasia is the reversible change in which one differentiated cell type, and dysplasia abnormal multiplication of the cells characteristic by the change in size, shape and loss of cellular organization. And epithelial metaplasia is occurring at the Barrett esophagus, squamous to the testicular coronary epithelium, and connective tissue metaplasia occurs myositis ossificans, bone formation in muscle after trauma. So, cell injury almost completed. Now, what is calcification? Two types of calcification are there. One is dystrophic calcification and metastatic calcification. What is calcification? Pathogenic calcification is the abnormal tissue deposition of the cell calcium salts together with smaller amount of iron, magnesium and other mineral salt. It can be of the following two types: dystrophic and metastatic. Dystrophic seen in dead tissue, metastatic seen in the living tissue. Also, metastatic association with the elevated serum calcium. In case of dystrophic, there is serum calcium level is normal. In dystrophic, seen at the site of necrosis, is metastatic, does not cause this clinical dysfunction. But in case of dystrophic, often causes organ dysfunction. In case of dystrophic, you should remember a mnemonic, RAT, for the example. R for rheumatic heart disease, A for erythematous plaque, and T for tubercular lymph node. And metastatic calcification occurred or seen in hyperparathyroidism, renal failure, vitamin D intoxication, sarcoidosis, milk alkali syndrome, multiple myeloma, metastatic tumors to bone. Okay. Now, reperfusion injury. It is seen with cerebral and myocardial injury. On the re-establishment of blood flow, there is increased recruitment of white blood cells, which causes inflammation as well as generation of more free radicals. Reperfusion injury is characteristic seen in cardiac cell, appears as a contraction band after mitochondrial infarction. Cellular aging. It is the features of aging include decreased oxidative phosphorylation, decreased synthesis of nucleic acid, protein, deposition of lipofuscin, accumulation of glycosylation products, and abnormally folded protein. The most effective way to prolong life is calories restriction because of a family of proteins called sirtuins. the latter have histone deacetylase activity and promote expression of genes whose products increase longevity. End of the chromosome are known as telomeres. Enzyme telomerase helps in keeping the length of telomere constant. Decreased activity of this enzyme is associated with aging, whereas excessive activity of the of this enzyme associated with the cancers. So end of the chromosome is known as telomere. The size of the telomere always constant by the help of enzyme telomerase. And next is decreased activity of this enzyme causes aging, and increased activity of this enzyme associated with the cancer. So telomere shortening, replicating senescence causing cellular aging, environmental insults which causes free radicals, results damages to protein and organelles, also causes cellular aging, DNA repair defects, DNA damage, or calorie restriction activities, sirtuins, accumulation of the mutation, which also causes cellular aging. A defect in DNA helicase enzyme required for the DNA replication and repair result in premature aging, which is known as Werner syndrome. And decreased activity of the telomerase is associated with the aging, whereas excessive activity is associated with the cancer. Free radical injury. Free radical injury is caused by the following mechanism. One is oxidative stress, second one is radiation exposure, third one is drug, carbon tetrachloride and paracetamol, and fourth one is metals, iron and copper. What is Fenton reaction? When peroxide reacts with the Fe2+, that gives Fe2+ OH- and OH+ OH-. This reaction is known as Fenton reaction. Nitric oxide is an important chemical mediator generated by the endothelial cell, macrophages, neurons and other cell types, can act as a free radical and can also be converted to highly reactive peroxynitrite anion ONOO- as well as NO2 or NO3-. Free radical is in reperfusion injury as are produced by the neutrophil. Remember it. It is the recent examination view. From the written examination view, free radicals in reperfusion injury are produced by neutrophils. So, next is mechanism of the free radical injury. It can result in lipid peroxidation, DNA breaks and fragmentation of the protein. This associate with formation of more free radicals, thereby making free radical induced injury as an autocatalytic catalytic reaction. Antioxidant may act by the inhibiting the generation of the free radicals or scavenging the already present free radicals. This may be divided into enzymatic, non-enzymatic. Enzymatic are superoxide dismutase, catalase and glutathione peroxidase, and non-enzymatic antioxidant are vitamin E, sulfhydryl containing compound, cysteine and glutathione, and serum protein, albumin, ceruloplasmin and transferrin. So commonly used 10 are for the substance glycogen. There is 10 carmine pass with this acetate sensitivity. For lipids, Sudan black and oil red O. For amyloid substance, stain is Congo red, thioflavin T and S. For the calcium, von Kosa stain or algerine red stain. For the hemosiderin substance, there is pearl stain, and trichrome substance, there is collagen appears blue, while smooth muscles appear red by staining. So H22 is produced as well as destroyed in peroxisome.